Good day, people of the Fish Tank Adoration Society that I have just determined to create. I have come before you to exhibit a couple of things. A, my fish look goddamn spectacular. B, my lotus is kicking out these huge goddamn leaves. Not only that, but you'll notice that it's got a runner up to the surface. Oh look, there's a lily pad. That's the reason why I got these things in the first place. And they never did produce anything. They all stayed kind of like this one. Kind of short, kind of dumpy, nothing serious. Although this one's starting to kick out bigger leaves than it ever has before. They all really have. I think it's all because I put this air stone in here and started kicking oxygen. Well, basically just, you know, breathing air in there. So, I mean, there's some CO2 mixed in there. There's some regular and all kinds of good stuff. We just had a small power outage, so I'm sure everything's still getting used to the water moving again. Well, look, we have a little snail pogo action. How you doing? All right. Make friends with the autosynclus. My hands are a little bit shaky. I'm a bit extended. Oh, hello there. How are you? How are you? And how are you? So I'm kind of excited. On top of all that, well, a couple of things on top of all that. I made a shroud, like I said I was going to. It's just some plywood. That kind of fucked with the fish. Anyway, if I can exhibit. Basically, my brother is redoing the deck. Because we found a bunch of rotten stuff, and so we had to fix it, bottom line. And he had a shit ton of offcuts, so I used some of the offcuts to make a frame, a little supported. It's a little jaggy back here. It could definitely be better. I should run a support across the back half, and I'm going to one day. But in order to make that happen, I need to fix the outflow pipe because of its down slope. Oh, battery's dying. Make this quick. Once I get that fixed, then I can take this little support tube that I have wedged in there out of there. It can move closer, and then I can cinch that in to that side. This side sits really snug. I did that perfect, and I am great. And that's been everything that is awesome about everything that is awesome. And I will leave you with that and go change the battery. All right, batteries are changed, and I'm back. There's a little close-up on the Fluval Edge 12-gallon. I'm not sure, still not sure. I haven't done any research at all, and I apologize about the red light, but it's, if I cover up the red light, then it covers up the microphone, and then you can't hear my dulcet tones of greatness. Anyway, as you can see, I'm getting killer new growth out of all of these. The hydrocaudal is doing well. I kind of pushed it more towards the front. And but I'm having a lot of die off on the dwarf sag. I don't know why. It was absolutely fine for about 2 months, or maybe, yeah, about 2 months. Everything was great. I didn't actually see any extra growth. They didn't send out any runners at all, but it just decided to be okay for a long time and then start dying, and I don't know why. I tied all that moss onto that rock and it's getting crazy. I'm gonna have to give that a trim. The Anubius nodes are doing well. They're sending out lots of roots. You can see them little bifurcations all over there. I'm hoping it does a little root on rock action. I'll probably have to push that crazy, one crazy root there down. There is one cherry shrimp in here somewhere. I don't know where she gets to. Sometimes she hides for a few days and then comes back. I do need to clean the glass, but as I showed in a previous video, it is a little difficult. Though I got some new tools off of eBay. They were pretty cheap. We got kind of a gravel spreading tool, kind of basically a metal spatula. I got some planting tongs, which I'm excited about, because I've tried many times to find different substitutions and it just didn't work. And these things feel already in my hand that I can get a good grip. And it's not going to crush or pinch anything. This feels like I can get a feel for things and be okay with it. It also came with some trimming scissors, which feel like they've basically been stamped out and bent. Got a little bit of a curve on them. But they basically feel like flat chunks of steel that somebody happens to have cut on an edge a little bit. We'll find out how well they work or not. I mean, the whole thing was $30. So, and that was after shipping and any applicable taxes. So that's about the size of the two tanks these days. I may or may not do further things. I'm going to trim that tall leaf and that stock. The leaf that was on that stock rotted away, and I'm sure that this leaf's not too far behind. I'm going to trim those two off with my new scissors if they work. And that'll be a much nicer composition, I think. That's about all that I have to say about all that I have to say. So there is the tank. And peace out.